Taking a little shower.
Karakoram style.
Simple traverse right, up left, and over 5,000 to gain tomorrow.
Man. Back.
5 a.m. A little too warm.
Made it 2,000 feet up. Taking a little breather. Then we're gonna keep charging. So sometimes you gotta bail. This is one of those times. It was going pretty well. Turned to a little bit more alpine ice than we expected, and it kind of overcommitted on the ski descent of this. So we only had ski boots and splitboard boots, which for my end, it's maybe a little uncomfortable, but ski boots climb really well. Whereas splitboard boots don't, because of their bad crampon compatibility. For moderate, especially snow climbing, which is more what we expected, James's crampons would have done fine. Unfortunately, when it turned more to ice, it's a total no-go. His toe piece here doesn't lock in and just has a strap, and it was totally flipping to the side and offering terrible placement. We did one pitch of maybe 65 degree alpine ice. There's just no trust in it. It did not seem safe to keep going. Also, we're pretty low on gear. Planning to do this fast and light. So we had 4 screws total, one of our twin 70 meter ropes. For us to pitch out the final 2,000 feet just would not have made sense. Sad one to bail on, but just making the smart move so we can climb forever. Make dumb moves, you're gonna die soon. It's
3,000 feet of down climbing. Whew. Exhausting. Back at base camp. Or high camp. Got about 3,000 feet up the mountain and My shitty ass crampons were failing and it just wasn't safe to keep going, so we down climbed 3,000 feet. Next time.
Okay. 5 a.m. packing our stuff before we go to Spantik. I just want to sleep.
Hello, Land Cruiser maintenance. And now we have 3 days of trekking to get to Spantik base camp. Hopefully we can use these bad boys this time.
Porters are throwing our bags and their deals. I think 20 miles to go to high camp, or to base camp. And we have 3 camps to set up on the mountain. Assalamu alaikum.
Packing up to take a load to camp one. We're gonna have a little under 50, maybe about 50-pound packs. Up there somewhere. Drop it off, come back down to sleep.
Camp one on Spantik. Surrounded by unclimbed, I think, 7,000 meter, at least 6,000 meter mountains.
Do a little bit of skinning, hopefully rip a few turns up there. See the summit. There, beautiful campsite.
Beautiful campsite.
Time to rip. We came up about 500 feet. Ski back to camp on. I love skis. I love skis.
Split quarters have more fun.
Carried a small load up about 17,000 feet. Rip back down to camp one to sleep and then head up to camp two tomorrow if the weather's good.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Long, kind of flat ridge line. Camp one to camp two. Another gorgeous day.
Here at camp two, we gotta shoot back to get our second load of gear and then we're gonna take a rest day here.
I'm skiing!
Alan setting the skin track on our second lap up here to camp two. Pretty steep for a skin track with type of exposure you wouldn't want to fall on. Very loose, wet snow.
Dramatic ridge line. 7 kilometers from camp one to summit, I believe.
And 7,000 feet again. 9,000 from base camp.
Made it back to camp two. 6.26 miles. The whole game. 7 hours. We're taking a rest day. Not really a lot happening. Just recovering, acclimatizing, enjoying each other's company. We're at 18.5.
Moving up from camp two. We've got this head wall thing. feet and some change.
Low angle, but it's hard.
Another 500 feet to go today yet.
Feels good to put the skis on, but damn, am I tired. We're at 26.56. 26.56. Camp 3, 21,000 feet. Got the stats from Chorus in our coffin tent. Ah, yes, the wet coffin. Wow, back at camp. My legs burn so bad and my feet are so cold. That was amazing.
I can't breathe.
That'll make the old legs sore. Looks good. Shoot right through here. Yeah.
Done skiing down the crux of Spantik. It's up there.
Oh, yeah.
Holy shit. That's scary.
Yeah, buddy. Alan bringing gear down from camp 2.
And that's the end of the climb.